North Korea is one of the most repressive countries in the entire world. The 25.5 million citizens of this hermit kingdom are denied access to even the most basic human rights, and face harsh punishments if they do not adhere to the strict rules set forth by its regime. Additionally, because of the government's isolationism and fear of economic liberalization, most citizens live in extreme poverty, making it unsurprising that many want to leave. However, they can't do this legally, since among the various rights stripped from North Koreans is freedom of movement. Because of this, citizens must leave illegally, knowing full well that being caught will lead to severe punishment, including death, torture, or forced labor. Additionally, even if defectors do succeed, it is common that three generations of their family members will be punished because of their disloyalty to the regime. Due to these repercussions, it takes a lot of careful consideration before North Koreans defect. However, considering the harsh conditions in the country, many have made this difficult decision, despite the risks. In fact, since 1953, between 100,000 and 300,000 North Koreans have illegally defected. Most leave with the goal of reaching South Korea, since the country welcomes North Koreans with open arms and provides them with citizenship, an allowance, and living arrangements. As a result, it would seem that most defectors should try to escape by crossing the land border into South Korea. However, this is actually one of the most uncommon ways for North Koreans to defect. The vast majority of defectors actually leave through China, a country that repatriates North Korean defectors back to their home country if they're discovered by the police, since they're considered illegal immigrants. In China, defectors must remain unseen and travel through a dangerous underground network until they reach another country where they can successfully surrender to a South Korean embassy. Given these circumstances, why is it that this is the case? Why do so few North Koreans defect directly to the South? The reason for this is the demilitarized zone that separates North and South Korea, which, despite its name, is one of the most heavily militarized borders in the world. This 155-mile-long, 2.5-mile-wide strip of land is filled with over 1 million landmines, is actively patrolled by tens of thousands of soldiers, and is surrounded by barbed wire and electric fencing. As a result, it's nearly impossible for defectors to leave the country through this route unless they have knowledge of and direct access to the DMZ. The only way to get these sorts of privileges is by being part of the North Korean military. This means that nearly any escape through the DMZ will start with being a soldier tasked with guarding the border. For those in this position, there are two main methods to cross. The first is by escaping through one of the regular portions of the DMZ. To do so, a North Korean soldier would have to wait for an opportune moment where he is not being watched by the other soldiers guarding the border. The reason for this is that all soldiers tasked with guarding the border are instructed not only to observe the border for intruders, but also to keep an eye out for defectors. Knowing full well that the South Korean government blasts propaganda and music across the border that may tempt North Koreans already struggling with the conditions in their home country to defect, soldiers are explicitly instructed to shoot at anyone who tries to escape. Once the soldiers' escape has begun, there are still many obstacles that stand in between them and freedom in the South. For one, there's a series of electric barbed wire fences on the North Korean side. To clear this first obstacle, some defectors have dug small holes under the fences and have used these holes to get past them. Others have waited for the electricity to be turned off due to routine patrols or power outages and then smashed through the emergency doors. In any case, once they get past the fence, they must next traverse the rest of the 2.5-mile-wide DMZ. To do this, defectors have two choices. The first option is to walk across the flatter portions of land, where they are much more likely to be spotted and run a much greater risk of stepping on a landmine. Because of this, most choose the second option, which involves walking through the ragged valleys which are full of cliffs, rocks, and other obstacles. Many defectors recall the difficulties of trying to navigate through these valleys towards South Korea during the nighttime, the fear of being caught while walking, and the dangers that the many natural obstacles in the area posed. After they successfully cross this zone and reach the South Korean side, defectors are met with more fences that they can either climb or dig underneath. Only then can they finally surrender to a South Korean guard post or find one of the phones located on the South Korean side where defectors can call for help. The second method of escape through the DMZ involves the joint security area. This area is the only neutral point where South and North Koreans stand face to face under the ceasefire agreement that was signed at the conclusion of the Korean War. The most dramatic and famous escape through the joint security area happened in November of 2017 when a North Korean soldier called Oh Chung-sung defected to the South. During his escape, he began by driving a car through the joint security area right up to the military demarcation line that separates the two countries. He then exited the car and ran towards the south, all the while North Korean border guards were shooting at him. When he reached the South Korean side, he collapsed next to a small wall that gave him cover from the gunshots, and stayed there until South Korean soldiers were able to recover him. Having lost a lot of blood, he was taken to a nearby hospital where he received surgery. Luckily, he was able to recover, making his defection a successful one. Any other escape through the joint security area would likely prove to be similarly dramatic due to the tension between the two countries and how heavily armed the North Korean guards are. Especially considering that increased security measures have been put in place since the 2017 defection, including a newly built trench where Song left his vehicle, and a fence on the road that he used, any more attempts would likely also require a fair bit of luck. Having looked at these two different ways to escape through the DMZ, and the enormous hurdles and extreme risks associated with them, it is not surprising that only about 20 people have successfully defected through the DMZ since 1993. However, considering the conditions in North Korea and the possibilities that the South offers, it is almost certain that there will be more attempts to defect through the South Korean border in the coming years. If you've enjoyed watching this video, please consider liking and subscribing. This has been Pegunus. Thanks for watching.